if you are gay and you are out in public with your partner being cute and gay and you see me staring at you, I am not homophobic. I'm using my gay telepathy to let you know that I am also gay and I think you look cute with your partner.
Because I hate myself, here's a new series on my account of movies that could have easily made the love story gay and it would have barely affected the plot and probably would have made the movie even better. And we're gonna start it off with everyone's favorite movie to quote, Mean Girls. I genuinely think this would have been really easy. They already set up the idea that Janice was probably a lesbian. I mean, I don't wanna generalize, but let's be real, guys. People that dress like this are typically one of us. Hello? I don't see a straight person in this shot. I see all a bunch of gays. And I think that this could have been the climax of the movie. She could have kissed Aaron Samuels at the party and maybe didn't feel anything, so she began to freak out and ran outside. Then Janice drives up, they get in a fight, but it affects Katie more than she expected, and she doesn't know why. She's confused. Why does she feel this way? Then at the spring fling, they reunite, they kiss. It's magical. Roll credits.
When I was in the third grade, I was quite the kid. I was just like a bookworm loner, played with the boys at recess, that kind of thing. And one day, this girl came along that seemed so incredibly nice, and so I befriended her, obviously. And so we became really good friends, and one day I was over at her house for a play date. Well, she said to me, "Have you heard the latest gossip?" I was like, "No." And she was like, "Okay, come with me." So we go into this computer room in her house, and she opens up a website, looks at me and goes, "Look at this." I look at it. It is Vanessa Hudgens nudes. I look back at her, she goes, "How does that make you feel?" "Caroline, I just wanna know how you knew I was gay before I knew I was gay." Like,
yeah, it's just something about them water bottles with the titty tops and...
You heard this song?
They're so pretty. Is that
a clear phone case?
Me too.
It's really funny that you bring it up because I actually don't wear acrylics, so yeah.
Hey, reporting live, it's Trap Bunny
Bubbles.
I wanna live in a mansion. Playboy Bunny was happening.
This could be us.
So back to what I was saying. I was fucking by. This could be another reason why I ain't making no fucking by. This could be another reason why I ain't making no problem.
Okay, hi TikTok. I really need your help, so please watch till the end. Okay, so a couple weeks ago, I moved into my college apartment, and the other day, me and my roommate noticed that people were writing TikTok references on their windows with sticky notes. We're like, oh, this is cute. So we went with "I need a bad bleep" to try to add something, hoping for like Addison Rae in response. Unfortunately, no one responded. They wrote "what," so they didn't really get it. But then my roommate gave me full creative control. Not sure why she did this, but of course I had to do "girl in red?" And I didn't expect anyone to respond, and no one had responded for a while, so I was like losing hope. Until yesterday morning when we looked out of our window and someone literally wrote "yes, girl in red," and now I'm in full gay panic mode because I don't know what to do. Like, I didn't expect this, I didn't think this through, and now I don't know what my next move is. Help.
Fight up, be into the end of time. Wishing that you were mine, pull you is anyone gonna tell those straight girls with the slit in their fucking eyebrow that, like,
hey.
What? I still can't believe you let me do that to your face.
Tell me something, girl.
Welcome back to Does She Listen to Girl in Red? The only game show where your gaydar is put to the test. Let's get started, shall we? Question one. Sarah has watched Orange is the New Black 3 times in the last year. Is she A, gay, or B, not? If you chose A, your answer is correct. Congratulations. Have you seen the show? It's good. It's not that good. All right, moving right along to question B. It is 80 degrees out and Jane has worn a beanie every day this week. Is she A, attracted to women, or B, anemic? If you chose A, then once again, your answer is correct. Congratulations on your very adequate gaydar. Make sure to tune in to next week's episode, Cottagecore Lesbians. How many houseplants is too many? See you next time.
If you're a woman-loving woman, stop right now. Duet this. Don't listen to it, okay? Just duet it. Just duet it, all right? I gotta ask you something. Just trust me on this one, okay? Just duet this. I'm gonna give you a second. Don't you listen to this whole thing, all right? I need to get your, like, genuine reaction. All right, now that we're here, you're a bottom, aren't you? You are.
God fucking damn it, Dave.
I've seen, like, a pretty girl with, like, really, like, nice, like, big muscles, like, probably, like, crush me in her bicep. Like, you know what? I don't think I've ever seen that. So maybe you'll have to, like, duet so you could, I don't know, prove your existence. That's the only reason I'm doing this. You know, I'm a...
Don't mind me just watching.
If one more girl tells me that she would never approach me in person because I look too straight, I'm gonna lose it. Like, what do you want me to do? I'm so confused. I can't dress more masculine because you're only into femmes, but apparently my pink heels scare you off. You won't come up to me and make the move first because you're afraid that I'm straight, but if I make the move first, then I'm seen as, like, weirdly dominant, and then you're not into that either. Like, should I just walk around with, like, a giant sign on me that says, like, I'm gay? Like, inquire here? If you're an older gay who's femme, who's also had to deal with this, let me know what I'm supposed to fucking do, because I'm at a loss here. But moral of the story, if you see me in LA, please come up to me. Chances are I want to kiss you.
Wow, that's a great question.
I you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits, putting on the Ritz.
If you know me, you know I love short women. When they look at you like...
I don't know, my noise just came out of my mouth. But anyway, back to the program. When they look at you like, hello. And I'm like, hi. Oh my God, it's adorable. And it's so funny because I say short women like I'm tall, but I'm not tall. I'm literally 5'7". And oh, I don't know why I love it. I love being tall. But I like short women because they fight better. They fight. They're scrappy. I love it.
Most women will look at another girl and think, oh, I wish I was as skinny as her. I wish I was as curvy as her. I wish my hair was longer. But I just look at other women and think how badly I want to fuck them, so.